It's Hot Boy. Do that count up for y'all.
Before Hot Boy would become the newest rap sensation to break out of Florida with hit songs like Goat Talk and They Don't Know. Before Hot Boy would team up with one of the hottest acts in rap, Lil Baby, to drop a remix version of his chart-topping single, Don't Need Time. Before Hot Boy would have 433 subscribers on YouTube, as well as 8,000 on Twitter, and over 780,000 on Instagram at the time of this recording. Florida has been a musical hotbed for upcoming talent for a long, long time now. And next up out of the Sunshine State is 20-year-old rapper Hot Boy, whose music details his life experiences, like the time he spent in jail or how he's learned to cope with the loss of multiple close friends.
Was that like a wake-up call to like move different or?
I always move different, but now I'm moving even more different.
When asked about it, Hot Boy always states that a lot of his maturing process happened while he was under lock and key. In fact, he wrote the vast majority of his debut mixtape, 2020's Cut the Fan On, while sitting in a cell during a 2-year stint in a youth behavioral correction program.
Do you ever reflect back the times when you were behind bars?
Being in jail, I feel like that helped me. That showed me how important my freedom is.
While Total Honesty paired with some of the meanest beats around are arguably what makes a Hot Boy song a Hot Boy song, what makes him a star is the story we're going to explore for you guys today. Hey, what's poppin', guys? Your boy Marlon Palmer back at it again with a brand new video. This one taking a look at the life and times of rapper Hot Boy. Prior to fame here for you on Before They're Famous, this dude doesn't turn 21 for 3 more months, and yet his name is everywhere online. So if you don't already know who he is, you're sure about to find out. Please let us know what you think of this video by following me on Instagram at DadDoMcFly or leave some thoughts in the comments section down below. Let's get into the story. Hot Boy was born Javari Latre Walker on June 13, 2000 in Orlando, Florida. He grew up on the city's West End in a neighborhood known as Pine Hills. In terms of being a Florida boy through and through, Hot Boy loves repping where he's from and has, in his own way, turned his home state into a lifestyle choice. He told Complex, "My presentation is just Florida. I can go anywhere and they're gonna say, 'You're from Florida?' I swear to God, everywhere, because of my hair, because of my clothing and all this. The way I talk, they're just like, 'Oh, you from Florida.' It's something I'm proud of. I'm proud to be a Florida boy." But before he was old enough to rep his city and state, Hot Boy had some growing up to do. At a super early age, he discovered his passion for hip hop by listening to rappers like Lil Wayne and imitating him while creating his own raps. After he grew a little bit older, he moved on to other acts like Rich Homie Quan and fellow Florida native Kodak Black, whose music he found he could especially relate to. Which makes a lot of sense thinking back to some of his music that is pretty melodic, like the artist I just mentioned.
I was trying to rap since I was like 3, so I don't really know. I just know I always wanted to be a rapper though.
In terms of school, Hot Boy was obsessed with math and says that if it were up to him, he would have rather taken math courses 4 out of 7 periods a day than ever have to worry about any other courses. As someone who has dealt with having ADHD, Hot Boy had problems focusing most of the time in school. He told Complex, "I had to take my ADHD medicine, my Adderall. That was the only way I could get through the whole day without having no incidents. But without that, I'd be bored." When Hot Boy got bored, then all bets were off. He'd start looking for trouble, and whether it was a fight, a riot, or simply breaking a door, Hot Boy had to be constantly simulated. Then around the time he turned 15, he and his mom moved to the suburbs of Orlando. At that point, Hot Boy had begun tinkering with music and recorded a couple of his own songs, uploading the tracks Switcheroo and Low Key to SoundCloud and YouTube in 2016. Once those tracks started dropping, Hot Boy began to collect some local buzz for himself around his high school, but at the same time, this young man was taking more and more risk when it came to his activities on the streets. He'd steal iPhones from people, and that type of petty crime eventually escalated to breaking and entering on a nearly daily basis. As a result, Hot Boy found himself facing some serious legal problems when his fingerprints were found at one of the scenes of the crime.
I was doing hot shit, like breaking in houses, doing crazy shit. They used to be like, "Oh, Hot, yo, you Hot Boy, you doing that hot shit?" So I'm like, "Man, stop calling me that." I didn't think I'd never get caught though.
He was eventually arrested and charged with criminal mischief and forced to spend 2 years in a juvenile detention program in 2016. When he arrived at his detention center, he quickly discovered that they didn't even have a radio there to keep him entertained, which meant that the only way Hot Boy could keep sane was to write, write, and write some more. Whether it was letters to friends and family or developing his burgeoning talent as a songwriter by creating dozens of songs.
Grandma's Blues, that was from when I was in the gram. Round 2, Stingy, Goat Talk, I made that in the program. Not the whole song though, the hook knew. in like half of the verse.
Of course, spending any amount of time under lockup, let alone 2 years, brings with it an infinite set of challenges. At first, Hot Boy had a hard time adjusting, often fighting with other inmates. Eventually, he cooled down for a span of about 2 months, and then when we only had 24 days left on his sentence, he got into another altercation, and his time at the center was extended by a further 6 months. Yo, I would be pissed. 6 months? I had 24 days left. Oh my God.
I was like, I ain't gonna never get out. So I just like, I'm gonna turn up. Then it just hit me like, you tripping. Everybody out there blowing. You supposed to be out there.
As disappointing as that must have been for a Hot Boy, more than anything, his time on ICE taught him that if he was going to make it as an artist, he couldn't lose more of his life sitting behind bars. He had to dedicate himself to developing his gift and turn things around. After he finished serving his sentence, Hot Boy left that detention center with his trademark hairstyle and a sense of purpose.
At first, when I first started my hair like this, I ain't had this on the back. I was in the program, so I was just doing some shit in my hair, bored as fuck. That's really all it was.
In September of 2018, he published his very first music video, Life of a Dog. But even though he was determined to change his life, his old ways weren't done with him quite yet. He told Complex that 2 weeks before his 19th birthday, the US Marshals raided his house and arrested him for stealing once again. For reasons that I don't fully understand, Hot Boy says that the Marshals ended up releasing him because while they arrested him in Atlanta, they couldn't get him to Florida in time before he turned 19. My best guess is that because of his prior arrest came as a minor in Florida, stealing something was a violation of his probation or parole. But once he turned 19, those prior offenses just went away. Hey, what can I say? The criminal life is complicated, especially when it spans multiple states. Lesson of the day? Commit crimes at 18 with 1 month left in another state. Don't follow anything I'm saying. I'm just joking. Anyway, after having dodged one last close call, Hot Boy was ready to finally embrace his musical destiny once and for all. In 2019, he released a track, YG's, which gave his fans an in-depth look at Hot Boy's experiences and survival tactics on the street. As popular as that track was, its numbers would pale in comparison to his breakthrough song, Don't Need Time, which he released on his debut mixtape, Cut the Fan On, in May of 2020. Dedicated to his fallen friend Wolf, this piano-driven song showed off another side to Hot Boy's arsenal. One that his fan base reacted strongly to if the track numbers were anything to go by.
I met Wolf in high school, ninth grade. We done fell out, but at the end of the day, that's my dog. Like, right before he passed away, me and bro was, like, getting real close.
21 million streams on Spotify with over 49 million views on YouTube. The song was such a smashing success that when Hot Boy decided to remix it, he teamed up with a big-name collaborator, Lil Baby.
Deputy shoots a man to death outside the Florida Mall. Now that man's family is demanding answers.
I want to know what transpired to him losing his life. We want to know. We need answers.
That video was dedicated to yet another friend that Hot Boy lost, this time to police brutality in August of 2020, when an Orange County Sheriff's deputy killed his friend Salathus Melvin. While the wounds left behind from his friend's passing will never truly heal, Hot Boy uses his rap songs as a coping mechanism of sorts, as well as a way to connect with his passionate fans. He told Interscope, "It feels good to show that because it shows my fans that I can really tell a story inside my life. They can relate to some of the real stuff." Hot Boy has said that his fans send him DMs practically every day, thanking him for discussing his emotionally raw experiences because it helps them deal with their own. More recently, Hot Boy released his debut studio album, 00 Day, on December 11, 2020, which features artists like Lil Mosey, Pooh Shiesty, and Toosie. So far, the most successful single off that album has been Malcolm X, which was expanded on his theme of addressing the modern-day problems facing the African-American community. Beyond these unbelievable success stories, Hot Boy is most proud of his recent performance during 2020 Rolling Loud livestream. Prior to that, he had never been involved in such a star-studded event, and it finally had him feeling like he belonged as a real-life celebrity. As for the rest of his story, well, I think that'll be a video for another time in another place. After all, this is before they're famous. What'd you guys think of the come up of Hot Boy? Be sure to let us know your thoughts. Don't forget to follow the series on Instagram, Before They're Famous, to vote on what's next. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.